Hey guys, Jengar here. Welcome to today's realistic review in which we are taking a look at the MB175T sitting at 3.3 battle rating in the French line. A ground attacking bomber that is absolutely amazing, or should I say an attacker disguised as a bomber. This thing is pretty amazing and I've had some good fun in it. It's absolutely fun, this plane. It's not the fastest plane. The maximum speed in this plane at sea level without web is 377 kilometers an hour, and with web 409. At 4500 meters, this is 350 without web and 353 with web. And finally, at 6500 meters, she can go up to 296 kilometers an hour without web and 299 with web. The plane struggles to get to 6500 meters, and she is absolutely best at medium to low altitudes, let's say. Especially the lower altitudes this plane is doing well at. By the way, what is the problem with the HVAR rockets? I mean, I used to be able to get a light pillbox with any single hit I got on those things, and right now it seems that you can get multiple hits on a light pillbox and not actually get the target. So I was fucking up my rockets, let's say, in a major way. But anyway, for the rest, this plane was performing quite nicely. Top speed in a dive is 646 kilometers an hour before it redlines, and 740 before she rips apart. Now, that is not half bad for a bomber between hooks. This is, of course, an attacker in all ways that she handles. Let's duck underneath here. We also managed not to get hit by any of those rockets, which is quite nice. And we managed to get a fire on him. So that is all pretty nice. So the dive speed is all right. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. It's quite a bit better than the regular cruising speeds that this plane has. Maximum speeds in a straight line. Control stiffening in this plane is starting at 500 kilometers an hour, and it becomes more severe at 600. Of course, the roll rate wasn't very good to begin with, so at 500 it really starts to already be quite bad. If you want to get guns on target or anything, you can basically do that before that speed if you try, because the maneuverability on this plane is actually quite good. Stall speed in the plane is 170 kilometers an hour, which is also nice for a bomber, huh? Firepower in the plane is good. You have two 20mm MG151 cannons with 200 rounds per gun. Now, there's nothing to complain about there. Absolutely nice. The plane also has one 20mm MG151 turret with a single gun, 250 rounds on that one. I used air targets on the fixed guns, and on the turret I used universal, as there is no air targets on that one. Otherwise I would have used air targets there as well. Stealth, of course, is also an option. The plane can also be equipped with the HVAR rockets that I mentioned, and to be exact, 12 of them. Or you can choose for one torpedo on a map like Norway, for example. So there is some versatility there. There is no bombs here, so it's just the rockets, which seems to me don't function like I used. They don't seem to be functioning to what I was used to on the HVAR rocket. They used to be quite devastating for light pillboxes. It seems that they are hit and miss now, but I'm not sure if that was just bad luck or I actually really aimed quite beside the pillbox. But anyway, I'll leave that for you in the comments to give me some feedback on, and let me know if you have also noticed a change in these rockets. So the ammo load on these guns is very good, with 200 rounds and 250 rounds for the turret. Acceleration in the plane in a straight line is average, and in a dive it's good. Not the initial dive acceleration, but once it gets up to speed, it is quite a good acceleration. The energy retention in the horizontal is good, and in the vertical it's below average. Climb rate in the plane is below average to bad. There's nothing to write home about, but you do start as a bomber, so you start on an altitude advantage, although with these rockets you actually need to go down. So you are diving in this plane using its dive speed to good advantage and then get to your targets. Use your rockets and after that start to engage the enemy fighters, which can be quite a lot of fun. And this is mainly due to the turn time on this plane, which is quite decent and good with flaps. The flaps rip off at 390 kilometers an hour, with those flaps the turn time is absolutely good. And when planes come from altitude trying to dive on you, they are of course compressing because they are so fast, and you will absolutely be able to outturn them without flaps as well for the first few turns. And later you can actually keep up with a lot of enemy fighters using flaps once they have slowed down. And it's absolutely joyous to fly this plane. The roll rate in the plane is below average to average. Not spectacular, but also not bad, as usually in the bomber class, you know, it's always quite bad roll rate. But it's not bad on this bomber, as I wouldn't dare to call this a bomber, by the way. It's an attacker, and it feels like an attacker, and in maneuvering it almost feels like a fighter sometimes. Well, maybe I shouldn't exaggerate it, but on a lower speed with flaps, this plane is quite nice. Overall, maneuverability is above average. Overheating in the plane is present, but manageable. You can easily cool off if you manage to finally overheat the engines, which takes quite a bit of web usage. Durability in the plane is good. It can take a good amount of damage, and that is quite nice because you will often get attacked by fighters while you're on the deck attacking stuff. People will think you're an easy target, but with the 20mm brutal turret in the back and the two forward facing fixed 20mm, you are not an easy cookie for most fighters. And if you're a good pilot, you'll know how to make use of this plane. And of course, as the average pilot is average, you will be able to wreak havoc if you choose to. This is an absolute nice addition to the French 3, and immediately one of my favorite bombers, we want to call it that, in the French line. This is absolutely fantastic. The back gunner as well, a 20mm MG-151, my favorite gun in the game, and you have three of them on this plane. And what more could you ask for? Now, this IL-2 is a very good pilot. He had a level 100 as well, and he was absolutely a good pilot. He had 2-to-1 kill death ratios on most of his planes, and he was very good in this IL-2 as well. And he was on 4 kills in this match, so we both were on 4 kills in this final dogfight. And the IL-2 is actually quite nice to fire up with. The 33mm guns are absolutely devastating, and he got good hits on my tail, and I'm very, very happy they didn't go on my control surfaces of my elevator, because that would have been devastating. They went on the stabilizers, and I'm still alive, thank God, but those holes are quite big, and I came away there with a bit of luck on that one vertical attempt of him. The rest I managed to avoid. He didn't get close with his other shots. And we are in the advantage now, trying to boom and zoom, trying to get a final solution on him. Here we go, using the flaps in the vertical loop, going quite nicely, plane turning quite well. Oh, oh, oh. Here we go, getting the aim on target. And there is my ace. Completed it with only a few ground targets, unfortunately. I should have gotten more ground targets with the old HVAR rockets, but these are new ones, I don't know about them. I don't know, with 5 air kills and 3 ground targets. Not bad. Let's see, we've got Final Blow, Survivor, Last Man Standing, and Terror of the Sky. We've got 90,000 Silver Lions and 6,700 research points, 11,000 for the modules. I'll see you in the conclusion. Hey guys, so here we are after the match. This is a very enjoyable bomber and it's absolutely a plane you should look at in the French line. This thing is devastating and feels very good. quite maneuverable. The guns are amazing and you have a backwards facing 20mm as well that can wreck enemy planes to pieces. The rockets should be nice. Maybe I should get in a few more runs and see if I can get them center target and see what they do on the light pillboxes. But I did get a lot of hits and a lot of failed runs. And with I went back to the airfield in the middle, as you saw, and I got a new load. So I had 24 rockets, which means 12 pair of rockets, and I should have gotten closer to 12 as a number of ground targets destroyed. At least 8 or 9 should have been possible, but yeah, I was quite a bit unlucky. I was also wasting myself on that normal pillbox, not a light pillbox, but just a pillbox, and they definitely are not working on that. I got multiple hits on that thing, didn't want to go down. You definitely need a bomb for that bigger sized explosive. But anyway, I would definitely recommend you getting this this bomber attacker. You know, I think it's an attacker disguised as a bomber. It's absolutely fantastic. Joy to fly. Great plane. And yeah, go for it. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the review. I want to thank you all for watching and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. If you're new here, make sure to hit the subscribe button. Become part of this community. If you are already a subscriber, don't forget to like the video, do leave me a comment, and if you really feel like helping out today, make sure to share the video with your friends and let them know about the channel.